And so I was following the Jeremy Lin story, which was late last year. And I was reading everything I could find about him. And one of the things about him they talk about success, like why Jeremy Lin of all these people, how did he come to emerge as a star? And it wasn't necessarily because he was the tallest or the fastest, he could jump the highest. He didn't go to the best programs necessarily, and have the best kind of training, etc. But what everyone always pointed out to was that he had exceptionally high basketball IQ, meaning he really paid attention to, studied, and figured out, what were the things that were going to be most critical for him to be an exceptional basketball player, to compete and to win. And so I kind of took that as a kind of an example and a good model for, or lesson for career success IQ and how that applies to the rest of us. And particularly here in China for mainland professionals, because it's a similar situation. You find so many people here in China, they're smart, they're hardworking, they're motivated, and this is the time of opportunity for them. Yet, you do see a lot of people that are either frustrated in their career, they're lost, they're confused, they feel a bit trapped. Somehow, they're not achieving their success for their talents and for their effort. And so, I do believe a lot of that has to do with career success IQ. I used to refer to it as career sense, and I've even written two books about it, about pursuing career success, because I felt like a lot of mainland talent was just kind of getting lost or not really focusing on the most relevant things that would help them rise above the crowd or to achieve their ability to handle greater roles and responsibilities, okay? So the whole concept of career success IQ, I think I would say it's rooted in self-awareness, okay? Self-awareness of two things, and the first one starts from themselves, about really understanding and thinking through what their critical career development needs are in terms of skill sets and particularly soft skills that would have the biggest impact on their ability to pursue and attain their career objectives. The other key aspect of career success IQ is a self-awareness of the situations and the environments that they either pursue, and once they pursue them, that they're a part of. And especially in terms of those situations and opportunities that can be leveraged or utilized as development situations. And really, if you're working in a multinational company or an international reputable company, they're all around you on a day-to-day basis, okay? What that really requires, I would say, is a couple things. One is a little bit of resourcefulness. You don't have to be brilliant, you don't have to be so creative, but just being switched on, eyes open, in terms of the situations potentially around you, where you can practice things like your leadership, your communication skills, getting the knowledge information you need, accessing it to develop your, say, big picture sense, which are all very essential, critical soft skills for particularly executives or managers and such. And then the other thing is just being proactive, being more, taking more initiative to engage in these situations that are around you, okay? I think one of the best examples, and I've worked with her for about 7 years, she's a former GM of our company. She started with us as EA, as the executive assistant to me. We were a very small company at the time. Usually when you hire an EA, you're not really thinking that they're the future of the company or that they're somebody you're going to invest in and develop their career. The interesting thing is this person, she recognized that, And however, she joined our company because it was a chance to work, say, closely with me. Now, I have other consultants and, managers. I'm really paying attention to them. So, again, her career success IQ, she recognized her environment, her situation. If she's going to get on my radar, say, or to get me to share things with her, to invest in her, then she's got to somehow get my attention. She's got to take more initiative, be more proactive, offer herself to get involved in things that are important to me. And that's exactly what she did. And so whenever we had meetings, she was sitting in there just, the managers and consultants were talking about the business, but afterwards she would follow up with me and ask me about, you know, things like why we were doing certain things, what was the benefit, and how she could support that. And she would just do this on a day-to-day basis. After time, I would just say, well, yeah, why don't you work with this consultant and see if they have anything that you can do to help them on their case. And she would just start getting more involved. Through that involvement, she would learn more and then be able to make her contribution and show her performance and results. And through that, you know, we give her more opportunities. She later got hired and today is the managing director for Greater China for a leading international recruitment company. She's in her early 30s, and I think, again, coming from an EA situation where she didn't go to the best schools, she didn't necessarily have advantages or somebody saying that she was going to be a rising star and to mentor her and such like that. So that's, that to me, the power of Career Success IQ. Similar to Jeremy Lin, you know, he wasn't somebody highly sought out, but he really identifies what are the most critical things that will help him be successful, to develop himself, to compete, and to win.